Hello everyone, welcome back to iLLPHOCORPHICS. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create a Facebook 360 degree image in Photoshop. You can use this technique and create a 360 degree view image with any photos. I hope that you will like this tutorial. So watch the tutorial carefully until the end, and learn how can you also create a 360 degree view image. Don't forget to tell me your valuable word in the comment section below. And subscribe to my channel. If you like my channel and my work, you can support me through Patreon. With your little support I may keep my working and make Photoshop tutorials for you. So support me and my channel if you like. Let's jump to our Photoshop. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have downloaded this Taj Mahal image, also some other image, to create this 360 view image. If you like to download all the images that I use in this tutorial, you can check the link in the description. Now first, we are going to match two sides of the image. Go to the toolbar, and take the clone stamp tool. Then open the clone source. If you don't find it here, go to the window. Clone source. Be sure to check the reflect. Take a guideline and put it in the image. Go to the left side, press Alt or Option on your keyboard and take a sample. Go to the right side straight to the guideline, and apply the clone stamp. Take your time and apply the clone stamp as perfect as you can. Now that's okay. Take the move tool. Now we are going to make some color adjustment to the image to pop up the color. Make a copy of the layer. You can also press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Go to the adjustment layer, and take vibrance. Increase the vibrance and also increase the saturation. Press the right button on your mouse, and select merge down. Next. We are going to create a new document for 360 degrees. Go to File, New. Select the document in pixels. Take 10,000 pixels width and 5,000 pixels height, resolution 300. Color mood RGB, background white. Take a name as you like, I will take 360 degree image. Hit Create. Next. We will add our image. Go to the image document. Take the image, and paste it to the 360 degree image document. Take the image to the top. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open Free Transform. And make the image size bigger to match with the document side. Put it down. And make some adjustments to the image. Hit OK. Now that's OK. Next, we need to fill this area. Go to the toolbar, and take a rectangular marquee tool. Make a selection of the top area. Then go to Edit, Fill. Select Content Aware. Hit OK. Deselect the selection. Next, take the brush tool, and brush those areas to match with the background. Press Alt or Option and take a sample, and paint it. Next, we will add some clouds to the image. I have downloaded some cloud images. Go to the cloud image document. Take the image. And paste it to the main composition. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open Free Transform. Then make the size bigger. Put it to the right side. And make some adjustments. Hit OK. Change the blending mode into the screen. Next, we will make a selection and make some copies of the cloud. Go to the toolbar, and take the lasso tool. Make a selection. Next press Ctrl or Command and take the selection to the right side. Now again make a selection of the small cloud. Press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer of the selection. Make a selection again to the big cloud. Select the main layer. press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Now take all the clouds and put in the perfect area. Make some adjustments. Go to another cloud image document. Take the image and paste it to the main composition. Put it to the right side. Press Ctrl or Command plus T and make the size bigger, put it in the perfect area. Hit OK. Take the small cloud and place it. Now there is some area you need to remove. Go to the toolbar and take the eraser tool. Now erase those areas. It's perfect. We place the clouds where we like to put. Next, select the main image. Press Shift on your keyboard and select all the layers. Press the right button on your mouse and select Merge Layers. Now we are done to make all the adjustments to the image. Next, we will add a 360 degree view code for Facebook. Go to File, File Info. Then you will see a box like this. I have downloaded a 360 degree XMP file. If you like to download this file, you can check the link in the description. Now click to the template. Select Import. Now find the 360 degree XMP file. Hit OK. Select Clear existing properties and Release with template properties. Hit OK. Now we are done. We create the 360 degree image. But you cannot see the 360 in Photoshop. To see are we create the 360 degree image perfectly or not, we need to upload this file on Facebook. Now save the image as JPG. Go to File, Save As. Save the file into JPG. Leave all the setting default. Select Save. Next, go to Facebook. Now we are here in my Facebook page. Next, I will upload the image of what we create before. Click to Photo Video. Upload Photos Videos. Select the image and open it. Give a name as you like. And share now. Wait some time to upload the file on Facebook. After that, Facebook will automatically create a 360 view image. Now you can see we create our 360 preview image. You can watch the image at 360 degrees. You can also move the image as 360 view. Now you can use this same technique and create any image into 360 in Photoshop. Let's see more examples. Now go to Photoshop again. Now I have downloaded two more images to show you this awesome technique. First, create a new document. Go to File, New. Take 10,000 by 5,000 pixels document. Take 300 resolution. And create. Now go to the image document. Take the image and paste it to the main composition. Take it to the top. Press Ctrl or Command plus T and make the size bigger. Press Shift and match the two sides with the canvas. Adjust the size of the image. Hit OK. Next, go to File, then File Info. Now click to the template. Select Import. Now find the 360 degree XMP file. Open the file. Hit OK. Now save the image as JPG again. Go to File, Save As. Save the file into JPG. Leave all the setting default. Select Save. Next, we will make another 360 degree preview image. Delete this layer. Go to the Hotel Inside Image document. Unlock the layer. Take the image and paste it to the main composition. Take it to the top. Press Ctrl or Command plus T and make the image size bigger. Again, press Shift and match the image with the canvas like before. Make some adjustments to the image. Hit OK. Next, go to File, then File Info. Now click to the template. Select Import. Now find the 360 degree XMP file. Open the file. Hit OK. Now again save the image into JPG. Go to File, Save As. And save the image into JPG. Select all the setting default. Hit OK. Next go to Facebook again to see the preview of the 360 degrees. Now we are here on my Facebook page. Next, I will upload the image what we create before. Click to photo video, upload photos videos, select the image, and open it. Give a name as you like. And share now. Wait some time to upload the file on Facebook. After that, Facebook will automatically create a 360 view image. Now you can see we create our 360 preview image. You can move the image as you like and watch the 360 degree views of the image. Again upload the third image like before. Wait for some time. And now you can see you can move the image in 360 degree. Also the other two images. And this is the way you can easily create a 360 degree view of the image. Now we are done. We create the 360 view image in Photoshop. Now, I just show you all the processes and methods to create a 360 view image in Photoshop. I show you all the tricks and tips to create a 360 degree view image. You can use any image to create this 360 view. And you can download all the assets link in the description that I used in this tutorial. You can use your image and create a 360 view image. I hope you like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, you can also check out my other tutorial on my channel. I hope you will also like. Share this tutorial with your friends and help my channel to grow. If you like my tutorials and my work, you can support my channel through Patreon. Your little support may be a big appreciate of my work. And don't forget to tell me what do you think about my tutorials in the comment section below. Leave a like on this video. And subscribe if you didn't yet. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon. So that you get all the notification of my new tutorials. And don't miss any chance to learn new things about Photoshop. So be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. So that's it for today. See you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing. Keep learning.